want to share with you three new succulents I got recently. This is a cactus, Rhypsalis cruciformis. It is an epiphytic cactus, which in its native habitat grows semi-erect or creeping over rocks. The stems are long and succulent. They can branch and twist as they grow. According to the label, this plant will produce very small pink flowers along the stems, followed, probably, eventually, by a bead-like purple-pink fruit. Being a cactus, this plant has arils along the stems but no spines, just tufts of white wool. This plant will be hanging in a place where it gets very good light, but no direct sun. Otherwise, the stems could turn magenta and burn. She'll be standing or hanging close to my other Rhypsalis, which is the species Pilocarpa, also a very interesting epiphytic cactus, which has the same light requirements. This is the other succulent I bought. She's not labeled, but I believe this is Peperomia nivalis. This is a creeping epiphytic succulent. I like everything about this plant. The creeping habit, the lime green color on the leaves, the shape of the leaves and their veining. I like everything. She is quite similar to another Peperomia I have. I'll take you to it and so you will see. This is the other Peperomia. It's Peperomia ferreira. And this one is different because it grows erect and forms kind of a small tiny bush. Both Peperomias here produce inconspicuous flowers, so they are grown primarily for the foliage. In warmer climates, or subtropical or tropical or even temperate, these plants may be grown outside. Indoors, they require bright indirect light, but they do tolerate low light. Because you see, they have these narrow and longitudinal windows along the curved upper surface of the leaves. These windows are translucent and they are used by the plant to increase the amount of light into the leaves. Are they smart or what? At least for now, this Peperomia nivalis will be hanging near the two Rhypsalis and across from the Schlumbergera rhypsalidopsis and my epiphytic fern rabbit's foot. Where they all get good light.
I also bought this one for my aquaria collection. It had no tag either. For the price I paid for these plants, they should really be labeled, but I bought them in a florist and they do not care about IDs. Anyway, I could not resist this aquaria. She seems so special. It has a structure I had never seen before.
They call aquarias the stone roses, don't they? Well, this is the first time an aquaria looks like made of stone to me. She is so rigid. She even looks like made of marble. Can you tell how rigid the leaves are by the way I'm squeezing this one? Anyway, I love the color of the leaves. I love the shape of the leaves. What I really like the most is the way the leaves arch down and point downwards. Unlike most of other echeverias I have, which leaves point up. The leaves have a kind of a pink tinge on the edges, and this may increase now that they will be getting more sun than they were getting in the shop. The leaves also have a bit of waving on the edges, as you can see here. I suspect this could be Echeveria subrigida or Echeveria simulans, but I will have to wait till she blooms to be able to make a positive ID or not. Leaves are not enough. Flowers and fruits are usually the most important features to identify a plant. And if this one is a hybrid, then establishing an identity will be even more difficult. But most important than establishing an identity is that I love this plant. That is what really matters. Well, this is it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!